Einen herzlichen, schönen guten Abend. Wir freuen uns ganz besonders, dass Sie heute da sind, trotz Omikron-Welle, dass keiner von uns Corona bekommen hat während der Probenphase und dass wir heute für Sie spielen dürfen. Vielen Dank, dass Sie gekommen sind. Ja, es spielt heute für Sie Ensemble Otrea. Am Dirigierpult steht Hanna Eisendler, singen tut für uns die Nathalie Weinberg. Und nachher werden Sie natürlich mit uns zusammen, mit dem wir spielen, einen Film von Melanie Hollaus sehen. Ja, wer war Fally Weigel?
So, to start by introducing myself, I'm Carl Weigel in America, or Carl Weigel, and I'm very proud to reminisce a bit about my grandmother, Vally Weigel. My sister, brother, and I always called her by her chosen nickname, Vally Muti. So she was our Vally Muti. I knew her as a child, of course, but then as a young man, when I lived in New York City, very near her for 3 years in the mid-1970s, I would say in kind of as a capsule that Vally was a multi-talented woman, a musical whirlwind is what I would say. She was a composer, a peace activist, a translator, a pioneer in music therapy, as well as a lifelong champion and advocate for the music of her husband, Carl Weigel, for whom I am named. Fundamental to everything she tackled, she had her underlying belief in the power of music to transform. In terms of personality, I'd say she was exceptionally strong-willed, determined, focused, and driven in everything she took on, and that was a lot. She was truly indefatigable. I'm not sure what the German equivalent of that word would be. Or to use a current American expression, she was a force of nature. With her boundless energy poured into her activities with ceaseless energy. These qualities served her well, of course, when they were forced with the necessity of fleeing Austria in 1938. She was the one who made it possible for them to move to America, to emigrate. So backing up a bit, Vally was born in 1894 and was raised in a well-to-do Viennese family in the first district. They were assimilated non-practicing Jews. Her 1 year younger sister, Käthe, later Käthe Leikster, earned her PhD in economics, became a prominent social democrat, a fierce advocate for women's rights, and an anti-fascist political activist. But she did not survive the war and was murdered in the camps in 1942. Their father, Joseph Pick, was a banker and an amateur musician who discovered and encouraged Vally's musical talent from a young age. She studied musicology, became a proficient pianist, and then applied her knowledge by teaching piano, which was her first job. As a youth, Vally was athletically very active, a skier, an enthusiastic hiker, and even a little mountain climbing, I am told. Though through this, she developed a lifelong love of nature, which found expression in much of her music. She married her composition teacher, Carl Weigel, in 1921, and my father, Wolfgang Johannes, was born 5 years later. The three of them lived in a three-room apartment within her parents' flat, until they were forced to flee Austria. While Vally continued to teach piano, her focus in those Vienna years became more as an advocate for her more introverted husband's music. This chamber and orchestral music became more widely performed throughout Europe, his prominence growing until his career was curtailed by rising anti-Semitism in the early 1930s. A little bit about their life in exile. With the help of the Quakers, big help of the Quakers, the Weigels managed to emigrate to New York City, where they lived on the Upper West Side. Always amazing to me, they were able to transport much of their Viennese furniture and even Valli's Bechstein piano, which had been a gift from her parents.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.